Hello everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. In this episode, we finished the guard armor, which was the boss of Traverse Town. So, we're finally talking with Leon, Aerith, and Yuffie here, and we're gonna get familiar with Donald and Goofy as well in this episode. Kind of set some things straight, you know, go over some tutorials, or rather, I'm gonna teach you about certain things, or rather, how I like to go about certain things. But anyway, for beating Leon earlier, you get an elixir now. So that's going to be something nice. I'm going to sell that. At least I plan to. by the way, just in case you didn't see that before in the other video, if you missed talking to Aerith during the, or before the guard armor fight, if you talk to her now, she won't give you a mega potion. Okay? So make sure you go get it during that fight, if you want it. If not, it's not that big a deal. It's just one mega potion. Of course, that is 50 money if you do sell it. If not, then it's a mega potion you can use. Not that big a deal. Trust me, this early in the game, potions, mega potions, does not really matter because you shouldn't be taking that much damage. Later, yeah, but by the time it's later, we'll have enough, or we'll have enough money to buy anything we might want. So, don't worry. Anyway, this is Jiminy here. Jiminy is the main recorder for how we progress through the game, basically. But anyway, so the first thing I want to do here is I want to manually change how Donald and Goofy play. By doing this, you go to Customize, and then you go to Donald and Goofy. Now, how I like to have them both set for now, at the beginning of the game especially, is turn both of their items to only in emergencies, regular attacks constantly, because regular attacks are just melee attacks. And then for Donald, advanced magic, I turn it down to, you know, only rarely. And for Goofy, for the support actions and everything else, I keep it to occasionally. As for the curative and defensive magic, and the normal attack magic for Donald, I keep that to occasionally as well. You know, we want him to attack and use his magic somewhat, but, you know, don't have it spamming until he's out of mana every 5 seconds, even though it seems like he kind of gets like that regardless. You can have Donald be a dedicated healer if you want later in the game, but for now, it's not really worth it. So, yeah, even later in the game, it's not really worth it. But anyway, we just equipped some abilities on Donald and Goofy. Not too big a deal. But anyway, for their items here, for their equipment, I'm going to equip the ability stud, and actually, I'm going to equip the protect chain on Donald, because he needs the defense. Alright, and for Goofy, I'm equipping the Brave Warrior. Well, I was kind of thinking about it here, what I wanted to do, but in the end, I do equip the Brave Warrior onto Goofy. Reason being is because Goofy needs the attack. See, Goofy actually, he's higher level than you, and he will always be higher level than you, but he has a lower attack, and his defense usually is greater than yours, but he attacks using a shield, see? So he'll always have a way of being, you know, he's usually alive more often than Donald, so that's why we want Goofy to have more attack. Donald will usually have higher attack, but lower defense, because he's the more offensive character. While you, as the main character, will usually have more balance between one and the other. And generally speaking, you're higher level than Donald, so you always have a higher attack than him. And you also have a higher attack than Goofy, but sometimes Goofy can actually out-defense you, but Donald usually cannot out-defense you. So that's why we want to kind of give more defensive items towards Donald and more offensive items towards Goofy. Not saying Goofy's defense doesn't matter, but like I said, he'll always have like a higher defense rating than sometimes even you. Rarely. Later in the game, you'll always outshine both of them, so don't worry. Anyway, so we gained our first spell, by the way. We gained the fire spell. Now, the fire spell isn't too great against things right now, but later in the game, it's gonna other spells later in the game are gonna shine. The fire spell is good against single targets. It does more damage to a single target, than any other spell that we get at the beginning of the game. but even then, it depends on how you use the magic, because if you use it just right, then other spells will still be better than fire. But anyway, so what you want to do is you want to get another ability stud. That's what I did. And then I also wanted to get another fire ring, and I want to equip that one onto Donald. Now, remember what I said earlier in another episode? I said I want to have at least 3 ability studs while I'm going through the game, so that way if any of my characters needs skills, I don't mind at this point in the game sacrificing one point of defense in order for them to be able to equip a skill, which is very worth it most of the time early on in the game. So let's see here. I believe I equipped that ring onto Donald, and we're gonna go not here. Okay, we're gonna go over here, and we're gonna get our first blue trinity. Right, I believe there are 17 in the game. This is the first one that you generally go for, and it teleports you. Now, the blue, each trinity is a different, has a different type of action associated with it. The blue trinity is known as the jump or stomp trinity. I believe it's the trinity jump. But all your characters jump, and it varies based on which trinity it is and where it is, etc. But for that one, you get a postcard, mailing it in. Being your fourth, you will get a mega ether. That guy still says the same thing, and let's move on. Now, there's another trinity near the front of the Traverse Town, near the doors, but I'll get that one later, because I have to come back here anyway, and that one I'm saving for, like I said, later. It gives you just money, and it's nothing special, so that's why I want to save it for later, because I will need the money later. But anyway, just in case you didn't notice, by the way, I did sell those elixirs and high potions, but I sold the 2 elixirs and the 2 mega potions, because to be honest, this early in the game, I don't need them, and elixirs, while they are too part of the too good to use club till later in the game, they're not too good to sell if you are lacking in accessories and you need them this early in the game, so just trust me. I mean, those type of items, like curative items and stuff, will always, you know, be easy to come by while you're playing through the game, but certain accessories and stuff like that won't be. So trust me, I'm gonna guide you through this game and make it really good for you, okay? So anyway, here we got a camping set. It's not too big a deal. I'm probably gonna hold on to it for now, or sell it later, but anyway. Just in case you're wondering about Donald and Goofy's items, by the way, probably gonna stock it up right here. Yeah, I'll fill up their items, mostly because I'm OCD, but you don't need to. Yeah, it's not that big a deal. Also, Goofy later in the game will become really important for basically restoring MP. So just keep that in mind, viewers, okay? Because he gets a skill which makes him very, very handy to have. Even, like, in all cases. Like, until Donald gets the cure spell, Donald won't really be that great to have around. And, you know, the only reason we use him in, like, 2 out of the 3 worlds before in parties will be just to get trinities, you know. But for like, final boss fights in worlds, we'll usually use characters from worlds instead of Donald, because they have higher stats and will do more damage and kill the boss quicker. But that's it. Plus, it's Disney, and I'm OCD and other stuff. Many reasons. Blah, 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 blah. Oh, hey, by the way, here's a cutscene.
There's something about this musty place. It reminds me of the secret place back home, where we used to scribble on the walls. Remember? Kairi?
Sora?
I love Goofy. So fun. He's like, Sora? Anyway, so this is the main magical character of the game, in sense of going to for learning magic. I wouldn't really call it that. He's supposed to help you with magic, but really, magic is kind of straightforward in this game. Well, I shouldn't say that, because there are some people I know who don't use magic. As for if you want to get used to learning magic, you come to this guy, and his name is Merlin. And in case you're wondering what movie he's from The Sword in the Stone, which is, by the way, is a fantastic Disney movie. If you have not seen it, I would suggest it. I believe in Kingdom Hearts coded, recoded rather, for the Game Boy DS. They included that Disney film into the Kingdom Hearts series. But regardless, you know, if you haven't seen the movie, like I said, I would suggest it. So anyway, after we meet Merlin, he unpacks, and now we have a blue trinity that we can activate here. He'll also tell you that you can train in the art of magic here, but it's not really training, it's just to learn how to use your spells if you're not completely used to them, that's all. But I am. I will be showing off or demonstrating exactly the purpose that he serves and how it works, but you know, it's not that. But anyway, now this is a much more important character, and probably the bigger reason that we'll be coming back here most of the time. This is the Fairy Godmother, and she will serve a greater purpose later. But not now. Later. Trust me. So anyway, here's the save point, which, by the way, we can use to leave. But here's the more important Blue Trinity, which gives some money and an item. You know, nothing too big a deal, but you want to get them all. Trust me. So out of that, we got a Mega Aether. Money, make sure not to leave, or you'll lose the money. Money. So, yeah. Anyway, let's talk to Fairy Godmother. My world has disappeared too! Yeah, she's. I don't think she actually sounds like that, but. Whatever. So, yeah, she's also worried about Cinderella, but she's fine. She's fine! Don't worry about her. She's in good hands in that prince, right? Her wicked step with Godmother. So, yeah, if you talk to Merlin, you know, he'll take you up here in his mystical chamber of torture. No, okay, that's not torture. But, yeah. So, this is where you can practice magic. To put it simply, you blow up furniture. I don't know how to phrase it. This is what you're doing. You are literally defiling an old man's, you know, furniture set that floats around. But anyway, you have two different choices. You can either have it stationary, which if you're new to magic, I would suggest, or you can have it moving, like you see here. Now, the tables are the most annoying because... whatever. Now, the other thing I wanted to explain was, you see the orange bar? That is how your magic refills. Now, the interesting... like way that it works is the orange bar itself also counts like as a whole MP number. I don't know how to describe it, but basically the more that you strike, it's like you gain additional MP. So if I fill it up, it's basically I have 3 MP, but it'll act like I have 6. See, so I can shoot 6 fireballs before my MP is supposed to completely run out. And even though the game will only really register that I have 3 MP, it's kind of just like a neat little way of gaining more MP, more additional MP through a fight. You know, it's a cool system, but I like the way they do it later in the series, where, you know, it's like a regenerative cooldown MP bar thing. So anyway, that's the end of this episode, so I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.